Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of The Steven Show, the show where we... The Steven Show. The Adventures of Steven, where we go on adventures together. And that those adventures take us to the graphical adventures of your... At least in this case. We're doing the Monkey Island series, and we're currently on The Curse of Monkey Island, the third in the series. The first without Ron Gilbert and Tim Schafer at the helm. I don't know that you could say Tim Schafer was at the helm on Monkey Island 1, but he was definitely a writer, so that makes him part of the crew, yeah. So we're on Curse of Monkey Island. Just to recap, we have made it to Blood Island. We are on the hunt for a diamond ring. A diamond ring the size of the same one that we gave to Elaine Marley, which cursed her and turned her to gold. We are, we're gonna see if we can find that. I know we've got a few puzzles in action. We've got a bowl of nacho cheese we don't know what to do with. We've got some hand lotion I'm pretty sure we need to get from Haggis McMutton. We've got a jar we need to figure out how to get some fireflies into so we can put them on the lighthouse so the flying Welshman can bring his boat over. We've got a few different things to solve, so we're going to solve these together tonight with you guys. Just a side note, man, Zelda's a beautiful game. Breath of the Wild, it's legit. It's like they put The Witcher and Skyrim and Zelda and like a little dash of Dark Souls into it. Made a beautiful game. Beautiful game. But you and I, we're not here for beautiful games. We're here for the old school. I ain't solving Jack. You're right, I ain't solving Jack. I don't have a clue what to freaking do. Let's see, session 3, is that what we're on? That's what we're on. So let's get started, shall we? See if we can get some volume here. There we go. Let's just talk to somebody, make sure we can hear everything. Oh, that's ugly as sin. Hold on, I got you. There we go. There we go.
Hi, that's a big bottle of lotion you have there.
That right she be. And don't you be getting any ideas about stealing it. We are sure to be needing it, you see. Carpentry on this tropical climate can and will prematurely age your skin. 'Tis but one of the many hardships a pirate must face daily during this barbarous age. Aye, and if we pirates didn't carry hand lotion aboard all our ships, we'd probably die from the chafing.
Wow, if I were doing a history report on pirates and I included that fact, I'd get an A+. We're talking guaranteed A+. And that A+ just might get you into the college of your choice. Think about it.
It's good to know. Alright, so, let's see.
How are the repairs coming?
Well, lad, things could be worse. There's plenty of lumber on this island, so we'll be able to repair all the major holes in the hull. We'll also be adding a hardwood dance floor on the leader deck.
Nice.
Hey, it's something we've been talking about for a while.
Alright.
So I'll let you get back to work.
Put holes in the jar? Yeah, put holes in the lid. So I've got the lid.
I don't want to close it yet.
But I need to find like some kind of sugar water or something. We got this thing going on. There's nothing at the lighthouse we can really do.
Luckily, I don't need to adjust it.
We've got the windmill. Is there sugar up here, maybe? I don't remember being able to get anything off of here. And those guys don't really want me to come see them again.
It's holding cute little shrunken head brochettes.
I don't think we can take anything.
No.
Honestly, I think this area is cleared. I think the main places we want to focus is we know we've got this windmill thing that we're not really sure what to do with. Let's go back through our inventory. So we got some recipes. I think I'm going to look at this again. Because I think there's something in the back that makes you drowsy, right? First hangover clears foggy heads. Makes you drowsy. Head be clear. Alright, let's not do that right this minute. So we gotta die, right? I think that's part of it. Oh, let's go talk to Good Soup about the, about his grandma, or whatever.
Again, how would one get into your kindly...
Let's refresh our memory a little bit.
I suppose you would have to die.
Alright, we'd have to die.
How's business?
Now that the volcano is erupting again,
I remember talking to him about this.
The reservations are just pouring in.
Ooh, that's
soon
a good idea.
Every room in the hotel will be filled, except, of course, for that one room.
Would you let me into that room?
No, that room must remain locked and undisturbed forever.
Let's see if
we
can
drink. I'd like a drink, please.
Sure. What will you have?
Ooh.
Give me a big fruity drink with an umbrella in it.
Good choice. It's a delicious taste of the islands.
Let's see if we
can
get some
lemon,
here.
Lemon, grapefruit, and ground beef.
Hey, don't I get one of those decorative umbrellas to go in my tropical drink?
I don't think we have any. No, I'm wrong. I do have this one.
Oh, is this an inventory item? Yes. Yes, we did it.
Ah, Papa Pichu. Here's your glass back.
Alright, so, I got an idea. Now that we got that umbrella, I know what to do with the windmill, right? Because it's got a hook on it. Oh, we so smart. We the best. Bam, bam, bam. Like Mary Poppins. Let's do it. Let's do it. I'm so ready for success. Come on now. Sounds good. You guys hear everything fine? Gotta figure out what's in this barrel.
It's full of fermenting sugar water used for making rum.
There it is, baby.
It's full of sugar water now.
All right, that's what we want. Okay, cool. Thanks, man. Appreciate the feedback. So let's put the lid on the jar.
I don't want to close it.
Oh
yet.
No, we gotta go get the fireflies.
It's full of yummy, delicious sugar water. Bet that water sure tastes good.
I bet it does. There they go. Sweet. We got it. We're well on our way. This is what we call the flow. We know what we're doing now.
And glowing like mad.
Sometimes it just takes a little bit of a break.
I can't use the jar with that.
There
perfect.
All right. Now the Flying Welshman should be. No? No Flying Welshman?
Luckily, I don't need to adjust it.
Okay. Well, maybe the Flying Welshman isn't there yet, and that's fine. All right, well, we made it somewhere. That was one big puzzle we needed to figure out. I think I know how to die, but I feel like it's not gonna do me any good at this current moment, but let's see. Let's order another drink. Unlike your timing. You're so funny.
Poor shit. I'd like a drink, please.
Sure.
Alright, let's see. Let's take that head be clear and put it in my drink.
The bottle's closed.
Oh, well, open it, dummy. Oh.
Darn childproof caps? I can't open it.
Well, that's weird.
I can't use the nail with that. That opened it.
Clever.
I'm not hungover. I feel great. I'm not hungover. I feel great. That makes the drink oh so much more appealing.
I don't know if this can do what I want.
It just occurred to me that mixing medicine and alcohol is a really stupid and possibly lethal thing to do. If I were a real person instead of a lovably inept cartoon character with the potential for a few more sequels, I wouldn't even consider it. Skull!
I don't think this is going to do me any good, honestly.
That's odd. It's supposed to cause drowsiness. I don't feel the least bit drowsy.
In fact, I feel...
See, you gotta die, right?
So then the Undertaker says, I wanted to be a pallbearer, but I couldn't stop coughing.
Oh, you crack me up, Mort.
So what's with the new guy?
Oh, he's been like that for an hour now. Passed out cold. He'll come around.
I don't know. I'm pretty sure he's dead.
I guess that's the end of the game, then.
What with him being the main character and all. Funny. I didn't think you could die in LucasArts adventure games.
Well, maybe they're trying something different.
When I should take care of him?
I love the fourth wall.
It's bad for business, having him just lie.
Oh, Mort. I get it. That's smart.
Rest in peace and all that.
The end. I love this game.
Hey! I'm not really dead.
It's pretty jazzy, like reggae-inspired version of the funeral march. All right, let's get out of here. This is me. It makes it look like I'm over in the corner.
I can't use the mallet with that. It won't open. I'm trapped.
No, you're not. Calm down.
It won't open.
About this auger.
That doesn't need to be augered.
Can't use the... Oh, about the chisel. The chisel is like a pry bar. Not a single point. Such is my life. Take...
Yikes.
Ooh, that was scary.
Where's that telltale pounding coming from? It's coming from within one of these coffins. From the dead. Dead that surround me.
I think I know what's going on. I'd forgotten this, and I'm excited.
The wrongs I've committed against. Wait a second. I don't have a horrible secret.
I'm taking these nails. You never know when you're gonna need more nails. All right, let's see if we can open this coffin.
I can't open it.
Yeah, you can. Chisel is becoming an effective pry bar. I think I know who's in here. Because I may have locked him in a coffin in the last game. Thank you guys for hanging out, by the way. Except for your changing your spot. You guys are awesome.
Phew, I'm glad to be finally out of that thing. Even though it was a spacious, comfortable model with plenty of leg and headroom. Well, hello there. Say, you look familiar.
Yes. Well,
of course, Guybrush Threepwood. You're the one who locked me in there in the first place.
Well, you see, I've been meaning to...
No, I won't hear of it. That was the best time of my life. Gave me plenty of time to think, you know?
Stan.
To think about the things that really matter. I don't know if you've considered this, son, but live burials are not an altogether uncommon experience here in the Caribbean.
I wasn't aware of that.
Not to mention pirate raids and deadly sea battles, huge man-eating reptiles, dangerous quicksand pits, trigger-happy do lists, and of course, those pesky undead. Have you ever thought of what would happen to your loved ones should this gruesome fate befall you?
No, but...
Well, of course, you have plenty of time to think about it. Or do you? I'm one of the lucky ones. I've been dead. It's given me a whole new perspective on life.
No, he doesn't.
A life that I'm going to devote
to
making sure people's life insurance needs are met.
He swings his arms constantly.
Here, take one of my business cards I've had made up.
And always has.
If you've been locked in that coffin, how are you able to have business cards made?
Now's not the time to worry about the technicalities, son. Now's the time to ask yourself, are you covered? Run along now and let me set up my office.
We're trapped in here. The door's locked.
Nonsense. This is one of Stan's cozy crypts, all equipped with a patented secure lock release mechanism. Just jiggle the handle there.
Sweet. I want his hat. It's like a cowboy hat, but different. It's like a weird tri-corner cowboy hat. Sweet. All right. So, now that we've got that, we come back. Stan's open. Let's go talk to him. Let's go see if we can get an insurance policy. It's a nice office. He really did a good job.
It's from the Caribbean Correspondence Institute.
I just like that the plaid never moves. It's just his arms move around with the plaid.
You've convinced me. I want to buy some insurance.
A wise choice, and one you won't soon regret. The question isn't whether or not you can afford to buy an insurance policy, it's whether you can afford not to. Speaking of which, can you afford to buy an insurance policy?
I don't know.
Well, how much does it cost?
Oh, that depends on a variety of factors. How much coverage you need, how much you're willing to spend, all sorts of highly complicated sliding scale insurance equations and such. But I won't bore you with all that.
Yeah, I know,
just
right?
Just let me ask you this. How much money do you have?
Well, I've got these wooden nickels.
I see. Maybe I've confused you somewhere along the line. While nothing would please me more to send you out of here, with the peace of mind that your family will be provided for in the unlikely event of your death, I have to run a business here. If you can't at least show me some collateral, I can't give you a policy.
Oh, come on.
This authentic pirate relic. A genuine tooth from an actual pirate. Only one of its kind.
Is that real gold?
Yeah.
The finest known to man. Not much spit on it either anymore.
Now you're starting to speak my language. All right, let's find a coverage plan that suits your needs. And you can rest assured that you've provided for your family well after your unfortunate departure.
I have insurance.
What are the terms of this plan exactly?
It's quite simple, son. When you die, whoever holds that policy gets a lot of money.
A lot of money? Wow.
Wow is right. Now I want you to be careful out there.
Okay, I will. Thanks.
No, I'm serious. I want you to be very, very careful.
Will do.
Awesome. I have insurance now. This is great. Is the Welshman here yet? Nope. No Welshman. All right, so next up, let's go back to the hotel. Because we need to convince homie I'm alive
now.
Hi,
guys. I guess you'll be wondering how I came to be back from the dead. No questions for the dead guy come back to life? No questions like, is there life after death or is there a heaven? Will there be adequate parking? Fine. Be that way. I wouldn't tell you about the hereafter if you begged me.
What's in this spittoon?
Yeah, gross.
Yeah, because I'm a spitting champion.
I thought if I died, I'd be buried with your aunt.
Well, isn't it obvious? You can't be buried in the Good Soup family crypt unless you're a member of the Good Soup family.
A member of the family,
sneaky guy.
Uncle Griswold, it's me. Don't you recognize me?
Recognize you? I've never seen you before in my life. What is your name?
Split Pea with Ham.
Split Pea with Ham?
Actually, my name is P. Hamilton Goodsoup. Split's just a nickname.
I don't recall having any relatives with that name.
Look at me. Don't I look just like a good soup?
No. You don't look much like a good soup at all. In fact, you look more like one of the Rothschilds. They always did have weak features.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Every day I wander the Good Soup Family Hall of Portraits and give my respects to each of my distinguished ancestors. Every distinguishing feature of the Good Soup Family is there in those pictures. And I see nothing in any of those portraits that might...
Yes, it's just frustration. And, like, the worst part is you drive to the parking spot, but you get there at the same time as some sort of jerk in a Porsche, and he pulls in, and you're just like, ah, what is going on?
I'm off to explore the rustic charms of Blood Island.
Endless frustration. And your car is on fire, because that's the way things work. Heh. I'ma be a good soup just by doing this. Shwabam! This is, I'm kind of stumbling onto this. I just realized that I could probably do that. I was worried about getting into the other thing.
Oh, there's nothing like family. No matter what may happen in the topsy-turvy world,
yeah, like Justice or Shoe Carnival.
I can always relax.
That's perfect.
In the knowledge that I come from good, wealthy stock. Breeding. That's what's important.
Breeding.
And culture. Just like Grandfather Lambert. Breeding. Culture. And lots of really
awesome.
Old money. It makes a man proud.
Yeah, I look like one of your ancestors.
It's funny. I don't remember Grandfather Lambert as looking so common.
Jerk.
Oh, weird. It's like his eyes follow me. Pictures like that really creep me out.
Yeah, I know. Breeding. So funny. So cocky. Okay, now recognize me. I'm your cousin. Or your nephew.
Look at me. Don't I look just like a good soup?
Now that you mention it, yes. You do bear a slight resemblance to my great-grandfather, C. Lambert Good Soup.
Clammy? Why, folks back home used to tell me all the time. You're the spitting image of old Chowder Good Soup.
You know, I think you're right. I wonder why I didn't see it before.
I could just talk about good soup history
all
day.
Yep, that's right.
Well, this is a wonderful chance for us to catch up on old times. What? Remember when our family first sailed onto Blood Island?
Do I? I still get goosebumps at the thought of it.
Ah, yes. When was that again?
1433? 1433?
Two? No. I can't believe someone of the Good Soup bloodline could be so ignorant of our family's heritage.
It's totally cool. So now I'm in the bloodline.
I'm off to explore the rustic charms of Blood Island.
Oh, I should ask him for a drink, big dummy.
I'd like a drink, please.
Let's die again. Because we have insurance now, so we need to die again. So now that we have insurance for our life, if we die, for one thing, we get buried in his aunt's tomb, which is where we want to get buried. So we can get the cursed ring.
This guy's dead again?
No, he's just faking it.
No, Stephen I'm K. pretty Wise. Sure it's the real thing this time.
Well, if you say so. He's an awfully fragile little fella, isn't he?
It's I'll a feller, but the subtitle said, hey. What the crap?
Well, hello. What a surprise you're dropping in like this. Now you see, this is exactly what I was talking about.
I'm one of the good soups. Aw, do I have to know more about his history to prove that I'm a good soup?
Hey, what an amazing story I have to tell. I was dead, but I live again. Who wants to hear about it? You guys don't deserve to hear a good story.
There's files. Maybe some of these files can tell me some stuff about good
it's
soup history.
It's labeled Good Soup Family Records.
Aha.
I'm sure it's just a bunch of legal stuff I couldn't hope to understand.
Let's see. Oh, a laminated business card. Nice.
Oh. Mutual of Stan, because you could die horribly at any moment.
Wonder
it's
if I
even
break...
laminated.
Wonder if I could break into that room with that. Let's see if that works, because this room is locked. Maybe we can jimmy it. Let's go jimmy it. Let's go jimmy the lock with a card. Yeah.
I guess I'm better at this pirating thing than I thought. It worked.
Maybe we can learn some good soup history here. I didn't even know it could come in here. This is something I do not remember.
It's so musty that I don't want to open it up.
Oh, let's pull the bed down. Oh, hello. Oh, yeah. I'm going to have to nail these down. I remember that because this thing springs up when you walk away. He probably got killed by being slammed into the wall.
I'm not sure if that's strong enough to hold it. I might need...
It's not. Sounds like he just pulled his zipper down.
There. The bed has been nailed down. That ought to do it.
Let's pick up the book. What you got? What does the book say?
The Good Soups. A Life in Pictures by M.M. Good Soup.
Who looked up the answers?
Nah.
You looked up the answers?
Wow. I'll bet his room charges are pretty hefty by now.
I did not. When did I look up the answers?
I'm sure there's nothing in there except one of those...
I haven't looked up any answers. Wonder if I could just... Should I just talk to him with it? Or should I just use it? I'll just use it.
My pirate instincts tell me I should keep this to myself.
Alright, let's convince him.
I could just talk about Good Soup history all day.
How about that first fateful journey?
No, I remember the nails. I played this years and years ago.
The one that... Baron Salmon Bisque de Good Soup began in 1621?
Exactly. He landed on Scab Island with just a spoon and a dream. In just 4 short years, he had formed the largest chain of all soup restaurants in the Western Hemisphere. By 1635,
yes, remembered. You're just going to have to trust me on this one.
Salad family out of the Caribbean.
It's not fun to look up answers on adventure games.
Empire that spanned the globe.
Actually, the Van Salads were not driven out until 1637, and the Good Soup chain of restaurants and resorts never
this
did
part
become
was really
popular
fun.
In the South Pacific.
Yes, we are. All right. Whatever.
You can give me a hard time if you want.
Well, son, it looks like
yes.
You were right. Welcome back to the glorious name of Good Soup.
I'm honored.
Now I can
and
die.
As a Good Soup, you're welcome to every benefit the name provides. Instant prestige around Blood Island. A 10% discount in any of
yeah,
the Good Soup
pretty much.
In the
That's
Caribbean.
Why you're here.
And of course, medical, dental, and a 401k. And
good
the
benefits.
Best thing of all, if you should happen to drop dead, you will be buried in the extravagant Good Soup family crypt.
Yes, right where I want
it's
to be
as
buried.
If all my dreams have come true.
Dun, 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 dun. All right, make me a drink.
I'd like a drink, please.
Right.
I'm going to die for the third time. Yeah, I know, right? 401k just for being a particular member of the family.
Oh dear. He's had a sudden and completely unexpected relapse of death.
Relapse.
And just as we were getting reacquainted. As his kinsman, it is my duty to give him a proper burial. It is my solemn vow. The youthful P. Hamilton Good Soup shall be buried in the Good Soup family crypt.
All right.
Sweet. All right, let's go find Minnie Good Soup. Is her name right? Wasn't that who she's supposed to be? What's this say?
It's a memorial plaque for Minnie Strony Good Soup.
I know, I hate relapses of death. The worst kind of relapse. Ooh, that's a ghost. Yeah, let's talk to her.
It's a ghost in a bride's gown. She looks very sad and lonely.
Oh, hello there.
Oh, she's a very southern lady.
Who are you and what are you doing here?
I am Minnie Good Soup, last in a long line of eligible Good Soup debutantes. I was buried here exactly 1 week after my wedding day. A wedding day that never came.
What happened?
I was the belle of Blood Island.
Hug the ghost.
How many
right?
people can claim that?
Oh, how the lads adored me. I was courted by the richest, most handsome men in the Caribbean. But all my suitors bored me to tears. I wanted someone dangerous.
That's a good point.
I wanted a pirate. By the way, what do you do for a living?
Flooring inspector.
Oh. Then one day, a real pirate sailed his ship into the bay. I fell for him instantly, and we became engaged. But he left me standing at the altar, and I died of a broken heart.
Wow. That bites.
Oh, I know.
Let's see.
Were there any other suitors you found attractive?
Well, there was one I could have fallen for. Young Charles de Goulash.
I love these names.
Such a radiant smile.
What happened to him?
You know,
the guy from the lighthouse.
Funny. I don't know. He checked into the hotel one night and I never saw him again.
Bet that's the guy on the bed that I found.
What happened to that young man you liked so much?
What guy from the lighthouse? I saw Charles, he had checked into the hotel.
Hey, nice ring.
Oh.
Was it something I said?
I hate this ring.
It's Can I have
it? It's passed down from mother to daughter in the Good Soup family for generations. It was to be my wedding ring until that evil
pirate the Flying Welshman
stole the diamond and left me. Left me here to die of a broken heart.
Where's the diamond for your ring?
It's gone. He took it.
Who took it?
My love. My honey cakes. My widow schnoobums. My LeChuck.
LeChuck is your schnoobums?
He pried the diamond from its satin during the rehearsal dinner. Oh, what a fool I was. He told me he was taking it out to get some fresh air.
Oh.
Where did LeChuck take the diamond?
Cad. The fiend. He sold it to the smugglers of Skull Island.
It's See, the Welshman so gets me to Skull Island.
I could just die.
All right.
Since you're not using it, can I have your engagement band?
This ring will remain on my finger until I have a wedding band to replace it.
Dang it.
How do I get out of this crypt?
There's no way out of this crypt for either of us. I must haunt this lonely tomb until I've married a man I truly love. And you can't leave because the door's locked.
Crap.
This is just a shade too creepy for me. I'm leaving.
There's gotta be a way out of here. What's this? Crumbling hole? Can I use that?
Hey. There's a hole in the ceiling of this crypt. I think I might be able to squeeze through. Wow, it's a tunnel that opens on a deep, dark forest.
It looks
familiar somehow. As if I've seen it in a dream. Or maybe it's... I don't know. Great jumping monkeys! A terrifying horde of stunningly rendered rabid jaguars! They're coming right at me! Whew. It's a good thing I couldn't get through that hole. I'd be done for.
That's awesome. See, I wonder if this is one of Stan's crypts too, and it just has that jiggle the handle
thing. It's locked. There's no way out.
Okay, so we can't go out through the hole. Can we open the coffin, maybe?
No.
Oh, we can walk this way. Aha! Crowbar. What about this crack?
Burry. I'm not going to do that again. I think I broke my skull. I'm all skull.
It's your own fault. Stop scaring me like that.
So I did scare you? Really?
Well, startled is more like it.
Oh.
But startled in a terrified kind of way. You really are very, very scary.
Don't talk down to me.
I really don't have any choice.
I saw you get out of that crypt. Does this mean that you're dead?
No, I was only faking.
Darn. I thought together we could walk among the living and spawn a new wave of terror throughout the Caribbean.
Love so Murray. What you're saying is that you only love me for my legs.
Something like that.
Right, I know. Just one thing. Can we pick Murray up?
Hey!
I've got an idea with Murray. Let's see if we can pry this thing open. We're gonna see if we can get Murray
the
married.
The crowbar won't work on solid stone.
Oh. Hey, Mort.
Hey, mister! Help!
What? Who's there? Who said that? Who's scaring poor old Mort, the gravedigger?
There's been a horrifying mistake. I've been buried alive in the Good Soup family crypt.
All right. This joke has gone far enough. You kids should be ashamed of yourselves.
It's no joke. I'm really trapped in here.
Crazy kids with your long hair and your Baroque music. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
You must love horror stories to own all these collectibles.
Reading fantastic stories about the dead helps me keep my mind off my work.
I'll try Mary talking to me.
This isn't a trick. I'm really trapped in this crypt. I drank a special potion that put me into a coma. Thinking I was dead, they buried me in this crypt.
Yeah, right. They did that in the book. Never trade lunches with a corpse. If you kids ever came up with an original idea, I might believe you.
Why are you wasting your money on all this bad fiction?
At least my bad fiction doesn't require over $1,000 in hardware.
I see your point.
It's referring to computer games. Crypt.
I'm not falling for your tricks this time. Just leave me alone and let me read my horror novels.
Okay, so we're not
going to go sulk in the darkness now.
Have a good time.
Let's see if we can reach for this lantern.
I can't reach.
What about this?
I can't use the umbrella with that.
Can we just grab it?
I can't reach. It's a glowing lantern. It's either a dead parrot or a very strange bat.
Posters. What can we reach? How do we reach that thing? Do we have anything that we might be able to use? What if we put Murray in there?
I can't reach. Alas, I can't use Murray with that. It's either a dead parrot. Nah.
I need to grab this lantern.
It's a glowing
something.
Lantern.
Oh, wait, hold on. Maybe this arm will do it. Ha!
Well, that can reach the lantern, but it won't grab hold.
Got an idea.
I've got it.
Hey, what happened to the light?
So now I've got a lantern? I don't know what that good that's going to do, though. I've got a lantern, but don't know what good it's going to do. Maybe I can crowbar my way out of the gate. Definitely not going up that hole again. That was a fun Easter egg, though. Oh, let me see if I can... You're right. You wanted me to talk to Murray.
I don't want to get caught up in a conversation with Murray right now.
I don't know, we might just be able to get out by using the crowbar.
Even with this crowbar, I wouldn't be strong enough to pry this thick gate open. I can't shed any light on that. Well, the hole is too small for me to squeeze through. There's nothing interesting up here anyway.
Yeah, that's just an Easter
egg. I better find another way out.
That's just an Easter egg. Okay, cool. So we know... We can't get out that way. How do we get out?
Nice coffin lid.
There's nothing we can really grab from in here, right?
It looks like he's writing a horror novel. It's called The Grog That Drank People, part one of a 3-book cycle. I wonder why trashy media always comes in threes.
He's really into horror stuff. Can't use Murray. Got my insurance policy, a lantern. Face. Let's see if we can get Murray to talk to Minnie Goodsoup.
That's just gross.
What?
Nothing.
Maybe she can give me a hint.
Hello again, handsome.
How do I get out of this crypt?
There's no way out of this crypt for either of us. I must haunt this lonely tomb until I've married a man I truly love.
And you can't leave because the door's locked.
Go into the light.
If only it were that easy. I'm afraid I can never leave this crypt until I marry. Are you attached?
You bet.
What a shame. You sure have pretty eyes.
Oh.
All right.
I'll just check back in with you later.
So I need to get out of here. Let's see. Let's read this and see if it gives us any hints. Probably not.
It's a memorial plaque for Mini Stroni Good Soup.
I think we need to convince...
Ominous.
What's his name? That I need to get out of here. It won't let me, because it just said I don't want to marry her. Let's see. Can I use Murray with the crack?
Murray, say something scary.
Boo! I am a fearsome skull! I don't think it's working, Guybrush.
It's a nice try, though, right? What's really scary? Death.
Fortune telling won't work with that.
LeChuck mask.
Looks like a Halloween mask.
Hanged smuggle bunny.
Cloying, yet grisly at the same time.
Dinosaur doll.
Warts it's called novel. The grog that drank people. I don't think he'd like that.
Come on, Mort.
It's me again. The guy who isn't trapped in the good soup family crypt.
I tried, but it wouldn't. I can't select the table.
Just come and look at me through this crack.
Oh, sure. I turn my back to the door and you thieving little hoodlums will sneak up from behind and tie me up. I read all about your sinister ways in my horror novels. So nothing doing.
Curses, you've seen through my web of deceit. I'm no ordinary man trapped in a crypt.
Well, what are you then?
An angry, deranged ghost. Faster than light ships trapped in some space anomaly, I seek the golden rods of Cthone to bring peace to the Shire. I'm an angry and deranged ghost haunting this crypt.
I'm an angry and deranged ghost haunting this crypt.
Then let me see you appear before me.
Excuse me?
If you were a real spirit, you could materialize in a ghostly form. It's all in the books. Well, let's see it.
Isn't the ominous sound of my disembodied voice proof enough? I guess not.
All right, cool. So we gotta do something that makes us appear.
I'm gonna go sulk in the darkness now.
Just making sure Sam was still sleeping. Let's see. Nick's shaving soap. We got Murray.
I can't use the portrait face with that.
Ghostly spirit form.
I can't use a balloon with that.
Maybe we can put the face.
I can't use the portrait face with that. That doesn't need to be lathered up. I can't shed any light on that.
Light. Maps. Big whoop. Laminated business card. Okay, we could appear in a spirit form. How do we appear in a spirit form?
I can't shed any light on that.
Could appear before him in a spirit form. Oh. Got it. Let's try this. Then it's all shadow puppets.
Murray, do your stuff.
Okay.
There we go.
Mortal fool, release me from this wretched tomb. I must be set free, or I will haunt you forever. I will hide your keys beneath the cushions of your upholstered furniture. And never more will you be able to find socks that match.
All right, hang on. I'm coming.
Great work, Murray.
I was terrifying, wasn't I? My demonic powers have made me omnipotent!
Uh-oh. Looks like the lantern ran out of oil.
Murray. There. It's open. Now shuffle off and give me peace.
Murray's probably my favorite character in any game ever. I should probably take this with me just in case.
It's useless now that it's out of oil.
Have you tried pocket sand in the fire? Yeah, we really do need a Murray emote. Okay, that one's coming next. Hold on, let me write that down. I'll try to work on that before I go to bed. I should have found something better to write it on. Alright, cool. So, we're dead now.
Well, Murray, are you ready to continue our heady adventuring? Murray? Where'd he go?
He jumped out of my pants. Alright, we're dead, but we're back!
Hi guys, I've risen from the deepest recesses of the underworld.
Nobody
Your curiosity cares. Is overwhelming.
And we've got a death certificate. I remember this part too. This one, the reason I remember this one is when I was in 7th grade or 8th grade, this part made me insane. Because I couldn't figure out what I was supposed to do. It was like, you have to die, and it never made any sense to me. And then a buddy of mine was like, oh no, you do this, and then you do this, and then you do this. And I was like, oh! So this one always has been fresh in my memory. Just because of that... something
Welcome
about getting stuck forever and then solving it.
That's,
you know what, that's actually pretty true, somebody who changed. Without Murray, what's the point, right?
I'm cashing in this insurance policy. Give me a lot of money.
But this is a life insurance policy. You collect when the policyholder dies.
No, honest. I was dead for a really long time.
And you just got better?
Well, yes.
Do you have any proof of this miracle?
As a matter of fact, smart guy, I've got your proof right here. A death certificate.
Bam!
Well, this must be some kind of mistake.
It's right there in high-res black and white. I died. Give me a lot of money.
It looks like I'm left with no choice but to acquiesce.
No,
right.
Just give me my money.
That's what I mean.
Oh, thanks.
Got my money. Got my money. Now, let's see. Is the Fighting Dutchman here yet? No, how do we get him? He should have found his way back through the water.
I don't have anything to replace it with.
Oh, crap. I need a mirror.
This pie pan won't do any good there.
I think.
It's broken.
Oh, yeah, we need a mirror. That's why the Flying Dutchman's not here yet. Where are you going to get a mirror from? Yeah, we get all Stan's money. There's a mirror here. Can I has it? Oh. Okay, that was easy enough. I kind of expected that to be more challenging.
Yeah.
No.
Did you just take my mirror?
No.
You're lying, aren't you?
Yes.
Put it back.
All right.
Well, crap.
Sheesh, what a grouch.
What was that?
Nothing.
I got an idea. Let's put that face there. Heh.
You just stole that mirror, didn't you?
No, I didn't. It's right there, look.
I guess you're right. Oh dear. I'm starting to look old.
I stole money from a life of drinking. Well, no.
Mind your own business.
So, I may have taken the money from a life insurance policy, but the terms were so loose in that even though I was still alive, I had a death certificate to show that I was dead. And he had no choice. So, that's not fraud. That happens. That's what you do.
The lighthouse is working now.
Yay, now it's working. Alright, where's my... There he is. The Flying Welshman has a life jacket on. It had terms. And the terms were satisfied. So I got the money. Ain't nothing wrong with it. I feel good about myself. I'm fine.
Who are you?
I am the Lost Welshman.
No, I wouldn't do it.
Ooh.
But Guybrush did.
I am the ferryman between here and Skull Island.
Hey, Mr. Ferryman.
Trapped
ferryman.
For so very
ferry me
long
banana.
In the icy ocean mists. Oh, how I hate that blasted mist.
Really? I like mist. I think it's pretty.
Well, sure, mist is pretty. But egad, is it dull.
People should say egad more often.
I'd like a ride out to Skull Island, please.
Thank you, subject to change.
I will never again dare that wretched fog without a compass.
Oh, I got your
Once
compass.
Once too often did I tempt fate. And just look what it did to my clothes. Just look at me. I'm soaked.
Well, you know, I just happen to have a compass right here.
Legit.
Then, poor mortal, I will show you the way. Rough seas and untold dangers await you.
You guys are gonna love Skull Island, by the way. It's such a Skull Island. It's Scully.
I'm not afraid.
I'm sculling this going on.
You will be. You will be.
He said it like Yoda. I love LucasArts games. Everything ties back to Star Wars.
You will be.
Even the bravest of men must dread the horror of this place. Steal your courage,
I don't
boy,
think so.
Now, before you gaze upon the terrible, horrible face of Skull Island.
That's a duck.
What are you talking about? Don't you see the skull?
This island doesn't look like a skull at all. It looks like a great, big, enormous duck. It should be called Duck Island.
Well, you see, you gotta squint and sort of turn your head and... Ooh, it's just so scary.
If you squint and turn your head, it looks like a bunny.
Well, anyway, see that light up there on the cliff face? That's Smuggler's Cave. It's run by King Andre, the greatest smuggler in the world. And his nefarious assistant, Cruff.
But how do I get up there?
You have to go to the top of the cliff.
Won't you be coming with me?
No, you must go alone. There will be someone there who will help you. But I warn you, beware of King Andre. He is as ruthless as he is bald. Good luck.
Thanks.
Let's go. Oh, hey, dude.
Hello. Can you tell me how to find the evil smugglers of Skull Island?
Beats me. Oh, wait a second. I think I remember something about that at the orientation seminar. Let me think. The cave is halfway down this sheer cliff face. Climb on board this dumbwaiter. I'll lower you down.
It looks pretty rickety. Are you sure it's safe?
No. Never used it before, but I'm sure it can't be that dangerous. I'm a temp here. The usual elevator.
Yeah, that's right. I am King Andre.
He's sick, so I'm filling in.
I guess that'll be okay. What's your name?
It's LeFoot.
Would you lower me down to the smuggler's cave?
Sure, I can do that. You must weigh no more than, say, 20 pounds, right?
Actually, more like 120.
Oh. Well, it can't hurt to try, right?
No, you're sure about this?
Oh, yeah. You don't look that heavy at all. Is that not tied securely? Here we go.
I think this is gonna go bad.
Okay, give me a little bit more slack.
Whoops!
Okay, that's too much slack. Ah!
Mary Poppins. Nah, I see. I did well. I made it. Look at all these bunnies. Stand aside. Hi there, neighbor. Got any diamonds? So where's this huge diamond you guys are supposed to have? Good afternoon. I'm the new Skull Island Diamond Inspector. I have got so much money, it's almost embarrassing. Ooh, that'll be funny.
I have got so much money, it's almost embarrassing.
Well, hello. Let's talk, Mr.
Good soup. Wonton good soup.
Very well, Mr. Threepwood.
Hey, how did you know my...
It is my business to know who enters and leaves Skull Island. I am King Andre, and this is my associate, Gruff.
Were
you
Gruff.
Looking for something in particular?
The Good Soup Family Diamond. LeChuck stole it, you bought it, I want it. Now.
Very direct.
Please? Sir?
Hey, Jamal, what's
but
up?
We have so much quality merchandise here at the Pirate Club.
Jamal, JV.
Our prices get lower every day.
J. Varhol.
Everything a pirate, or pirate in training, could possibly want is here. For the right price.
What you want?
You're such an odd person.
The Good Soup Diamond is the centerpiece of my collection. The fantastic energy flowing through it is the key to all my power.
So, can I have it?
Of course you can't have it. Unless you were to give me something in return.
Yes. That diamond belongs in a museum.
That diamond belongs in a museum.
So do post-impressionist paintings, Mr. Threepwood. So do post-impressionist paintings.
What the heck is that supposed to mean?
One day, you will understand.
Maybe we could make a deal.
As you wish. You are a formidable opponent, Mr. Threepwood. But it looks as if our game of cat and mouse must cease.
I wonder what I have to give him.
It is a perfect diamond. One of the largest I've ever seen.
I'll take it.
And so it comes with a very large price.
Enough with the hard
sell.
Definitely. How much?
It will cost you an awful lot of money. Do you have that much?
Well, I have a lot of money.
Not enough.
My partner is right. We can't give it to you for anything less than an awful lot of money. But perhaps we can make a deal.
I'm
My
listening.
Partner and I are very fond of cards. Poker in particular.
I have a card.
How about a little wager? If you can defeat us at poker, you win the diamond.
Sounds fair.
Yes, fair.
These bunch of savages, they're going to try to cheat me.
Could you stop laughing like that? It's very unnerving.
So, Mr. Threepwood,
Blood money.
The question is, do you care to join us in a game of cards?
Yeah, deal
Sounds
me in.
Sounds fun. Deal me in, Baldy.
You will have to pay to enter the game.
Well, how much do I need?
Not very much.
Sure, I can handle that. This is a lot of money. I better only give them part of it.
Have you ever played poker before, Mr. Threepwood?
No. Would you believe this is my very first time?
I think I'm going to use that death card
then
for
I'll
something.
Give you a brief
we'll see how it goes.
Explanation. The game is the simplest variety of five-card stud. I deal five cards to each of us. We show our cards to each other, and the player with the best hand wins.
Well, how do I know what makes the best
hand? Yeah.
If you have any questions, just ask us. You do trust us, don't you?
I trust you both are the lowest scum of society.
Of course I trust you.
Very well. Let us begin.
No whammies. No whammies.
Take a moment to look at your cards.
Weak hand.
Two of spades, three of hearts, four of clubs, eight of clubs, and king of diamonds. What a terrible hand. The future is in my hands.
Can I put this in there?
I've got an ace of death.
I have a pair. You lose, Mr. Threepwood. Perhaps you should try again.
You bet. I'm going to win that diamond.
Put up your side of the wager, Mr. Threepwood. Very well.
An ace of death.
Good cards. Daddy needs to lift the pirate curse.
Take a moment to look at your cards.
Two of spades, three of hearts. Hey, wait a second. This is the exact same hand as I had last time. How's that even possible?
Ah, that's an interesting turn of luck.
Hey, Dress. Good to see you. They have this. They gave me the same cards. I don't think there's anything I can do to work around that. Magic.
Magic wand has no effect on that. I can't use the chisel with that. Well, I've got a pair. The King of Diamonds and the King of Insurance Salesmen.
I have a royal flush. It seems you've lost again. Maybe your luck will improve. Perhaps you should try again.
No. We're going to go figure out how to get past this. Give me shady cards. I'm going to take the Smuggle Bunny. That's what I'm going to do.
It's too adorable. I don't want to lose my dark, piratey edge.
What's up here? Oh, okay. Oop, that's not what I wanted to do.
I still say it looks like a duck.
That's entirely too many veggies on your pizza. Oh, well, that's good. At least I can go in and out without much issue. What's that little thing he has? Can I talk to you?
He's not much of a talker.
How would I get... How do I get a better hand at cards? Captain Nick shaving soap. I don't even know what I would do with that. Whoa.
Keep that door closed!
Sorry, I just wanted to make sure Mr. Threepwood made it down all right.
Oh, can we open the door?
Smuggling by candlelight. Very.
What do we do to make that door open? Oh, I know what we can do. No, I don't. I don't have a clue.
I couldn't help noticing those adorable
Smuggle
Bunnies.
Stab him with the chisel.
Ah, the Smuggle Bunnies. One of our most popular items. Each one comes with a cleverly hidden pouch just above this small intestine.
Great, I'll take one.
None of them contains the diamond.
Oh, never mind.
Nah.
I want to play for the diamond again.
Put up your side of the wager, Mr. Threepwood. Very well. Let us begin.
No whammies, no whammies.
Take a moment to look at your cards. Now, Mr. Threepwood, that would be stealing.
Please stop laughing like that.
Let's see. Got cards. This isn't gonna.
These aren't even real playing cards. What game is this?
I got a tarot card.
Fortune telling won't work with that.
Got brochures and whipping cream and magnets, and gold, cookbooks.
That doesn't need to be augured.
I'm going to lunch if anybody needs me.
Shut that door, there's a draft.
That's gotta have something to do with it, but it didn't let me make any actions while he was banging on the door. I mean, we've tried the two other things. Bah.
Giving up, Guybrush?
I was just stretching my legs. I want to keep playing.
All right.
Fortune telling won't work with that. 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 Fortune telling won't work with that.
Try and cut it up.
Fortune telling won't work with that.
Whatever.
I've got an ace of death.
I have a pair. You lose, Mr. Threepwood. Don't give up just yet. Perhaps you should try again.
No.
No thanks.
I don't know how to win this.
I don't think he'd like that.
What can I use?
What's this? I can only make out page 243. A compass is a magnetized bit of metal floating in a solution. I don't think he'd like that.
Let's see. Maybe this guy knows something.
It's LeFoot.
Yes?
Never mind. I can't use it myself. Someone has to lower me down.
Cloud? What? Really? You look at a cloud.
Oh, cool. It looks like a giant flying snail.
Oh, where do we go, man? How do we do this? How do we figure out what... How do we beat them in poker? I swear it's got to have something to do with this chandelier draft.
Hey, Dirt.
Look, but don't touch.
Gotcha.
All right, let's go back across.
Excuse me. I'd like to go back to Blood Island.
Me too. This place gives me the creeps.
There might be something I can use once I get back over here. You know what? That wouldn't be a bad idea, but I think that would be, well, yeah, that's a bad idea. But really consider, that's a bad idea. I'm gonna go, so Minnie Good Soup needs, this is her buddy, I think. This is who she was gonna marry.
Wow. I'll bet his room charges are pretty hefty by now. Well, I wouldn't know what to say. Gross.
Oh, this is what, oh, okay, let's do this. Let's catapult him out of here.
This won't give me enough leverage.
We'll do something, right? While we're doing nothing. And this will be fun. He's free. Creepy.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hear you come in. I was just... Charles?
It's like Pulp
Charles
Fiction.
De Goulon,
I had to stab her
really
multiple
you?
Times.
Minnie, it's been so long.
She does have cards.
Oh, Charles, it has.
Maybe she has more. She
it
gave
has.
Me the tarot card.
You look so different.
Really? Why, you look exactly the same.
Oh, Charles, how you flatter me. Oh, but you must go now.
But why? Now that I've found you again after all these years.
What would our families say if they knew we were alone together on such a romantic night?
Minnie, this may sound rash, but I love you, Minnie Goodsoup.
Aww.
Oh, Charles, you mustn't.
Oh, I can't help it. I've always loved you. Do you hear? I've always loved you, Minnie, and I always will.
This is beautiful.
Come away with me now.
Elope? Oh, but Charles, it just isn't done. Think of the scandal it would cause.
To heck with the scandal, Minnie.
Oh.
Marry me.
Oh, yes, Charles. Yes, 1,000 times.
Sabak.
Then kiss me, my love.
Knights of the Republic? Isn't that where that came from? Oh, look, an actual cutscene. And I get it. That's for me. That's mine. I got an engagement ring band. Sweet. Okay, now I just need the diamond to go with it, which I gotta get from the smugglers. Dude, what if he is? What will we have uncovered? Cutscene. Yes. Like cutscenes, it means we're getting somewhere.
Have you found her, you cadaverous canine?
Yeah, no
Nope, she's not on Plunder Island, Captain LeChuck.
Then scour the seas, you ossified rats! Hunt them down, then bring them to me. Find me Guybrush Threepwood. It's with him that you'll find Elaine. Burn down every island in the Caribbean if you have to. But bring me my bride! And more slaw! Curse those villains! They never give you enough slaw with these bad meals.
Love that. All right. Crap, we need this hand lotion. Can I just have a pump? Just a pump of hand lotion, put it in the pie pan.
This pie pan won't do any good there.
Why do I have a pie pan? Oh, I remember I went pie panning. Pie pan? I went panning. Got this auger too. What the crap do I have an auger for? I just want to pump it.
Leave that lotion. It'd be for the chafing hands of we shipwrights.
I just want one pump of lotion. Maybe I can give you something. What does that do with the... What the crap am I supposed to do with the nacho cheese? I got a pot of nacho cheese. I don't know what the devil to do with it.
This pie pan won't do any good.
Can I auger the cheese?
That doesn't need to be augered. That melted cheese looks just like yellow tar.
Yellow tar. Yeah, but what good is the yellow tar?
I'm not going to carry around that heavy iron.
Heavy iron pot for no reason?
That doesn't need to be lathered up.
Oh. Yellow tar. Oh, Pazek, thank you. It's not your cheese. Yeah, I know. I just don't know. I think I've got an idea, though. I think I can use this Nick shaving soap to get the diamond ring off Elaine's finger.
This stuff just isn't slippery enough to do the trick.
It's not Joe's. That's the best. What do I do with that nacho cheese? It looks just like yellow tar. He says it looks like yellow tar. But what does that do for me? Like, what puzzle would require yellow tar? Oh, let's go talk to the card lady again. We talked about that. I'm so glad you can double click in this game. That's not a terrible joke. It's the best joke.
There must be some mistake. Read my tarot cards again.
There is no mistaking your fate, Guybrush. The cards do not lie. But if you insist...
Yes, I insist.
Once again, it is death.
Oh, cool. I can get her to give me a full hand of death cards. Five of a kind, right?
I'm feeling luckier. Give me another tarot.
Dude, Hazcat, you did this.
It is your destiny.
You get credit for solving this puzzle.
Let's see what the cards say this time.
The card says death.
Are you sure you're not dealing from the bottom of the deck?
Remember that curse I told you about?
That's a good question. Okay. I'm just going to call it five of a kind. No, I don't want to talk to the card or eat it. That's three. Hit me.
Death.
How many of those cards do you have, anyway?
All right, give me one more.
How about giving me one more tarot reading?
And then we're gonna go get our ring.
Guybrush, the fates have conspired against you.
It's gonna
no
be today.
Can interfere.
It's your gonna be a thing today.
Okay, I get your point. I really do. Just one more time for Guybrush. Let me guess. Death?
Leave this place.
Huh?
Look at her eye.
You are putting us all in grave danger. Your very presence will bring us nothing but sickness, tragedy, and death.
Oh, yeah? Well...
Demon! Demon!
That's awesome. Okay, we got this. We're going back to the cave. I did get the stink eye. Did you see that thing? It was like twitching. Twitching. Twitching on Twitch. Too legit to twitch, buddy. So lame. I'm such a nerd. I don't even know why you guys watch me. Hey, by the way, I'm really glad you all could be here. You're awesome. Super awesome. Steph is downstairs playing Zelda. Freaking incredible game.
I'd like a ride out to Skull Island, please.
All right,
and I picked up Horizon Zero Dawn. But granted, the TV is occupied by all the Zelda. Might be a little while. But I'm really excited about Horizon. I've heard nothing but good things. Nothing but good things. That's the eye of a tank whose clothy is trying to aggro the X-Pack. It's the best.
I want to play for the diamond again.
Yo, dog. Deal
Come
them
on,
cards.
Sevens. Five of a kind. Right there. Not even you guys can beat five of a kind.
You're correct, Mr. Threepwood. We cannot beat five of a kind. The question remains, however, whether or not you can beat a pair.
A pair?
A pair of murderous smugglers.
Huh?
Us, Mr. Threepwood. I am talking about us.
We're gonna kill you.
Oh, I get it. Whether or not you can beat a pair, that's pretty clever. Now, gentlemen. Let's not be too hasty.
There's a delivery man out here with a package.
You idiot! You blew out the lights!
I got the diamond.
Not for long, you little...
Ouch! Hit him, not me, you cretin!
Who are you calling a boor?
There he goes! Hit him!
Got what I needed from the smugglers.
Good. Let us leave this place of evil. Good luck on the rest of your adventures, Guybrush.
What? You can't mean...
I'm afraid so. This work is too dangerous for me. I'm going to find a more stable, secure line of work. I hear there's still an opening for a chef on Scab Island.
Well, you'll be sorely missed.
I know, but my destiny lies out there,
Egad, cretin. Those words need to be in the vocabulary.
Farewell, good friend Welshman.
And the Welshman is off, and he's back.
Oh, wait. Where'd you say Scab Island was again?
East by northeast. You can't miss it.
Oh, thanks a bunch.
We were the chef on Scab Island for a minute. We made a lot of money that way.
Whoops, I forgot to tell him that a magnetized pin will only have compass-like properties for a short time.
Oops.
It's a massive diamond engagement ring.
All right, now we gotta figure out how to get this stupid thing off of, Oh, back on Monkey Island.
Another group of recruits for my army of the undead. Now, how goes the search for my bride to be? Where's Dingy Dog?
I found him! Yeah. Oh, golly, oh gosh! Yeah. That's right! They're on Blood Island, sir.
Hit them!
I love that LeChuck has a beard of fire now. All right, Haggis, I just want one pump of your stupid lotion. How do we get it? 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 I know the nacho cheese has something. The nacho cheese is something. It's yellow tar. It's got a purpose. But what purpose does it have? made nacho cheese. I don't know. I don't know what it's for. Fondue?
I can't use the chisel with that.
I'm using stuff with the cooking pot. Put the tofu in
there.
I
don't want to cook the tofu.
Recipe no. book with the cooking pot? No.
I can't use the mallet with that. That melted cheese looks just like yellow tar.
Yellow tar. Yeah, right. Like, that's a good question.
I'm not going to carry around that heavy iron pot for no reason.
Oh, eat contents.
Come to think of it, I don't want any fresh nacho cheese. I can't use a balloon. That doesn't need to be lathered up.
Something needs to be lathered. What needs to be lathered? Who needs lathering? There's nothing here that I can think of that I need. Right? Old blind pew. I was thinking, like, that's where my brain was going, is like maybe I use it somehow with the lotion puzzle. Yeah, let me talk to Haggis a little bit more. Maybe I can get a hint.
Haggis?
Aye.
Mutiny's a big step. Are you sure you won't reconsider?
Aye, lad, we're all agreed. We'd rather feel the spray of detangler in our faces than the spray of the ocean.
You mutineers had best beware.
Beware of what?
Well, for one thing.
I put a terrible curse on you. You'll be driven to madness by the shame of your own guilt. Ah, there we go.
The sea hates a deserter, and she'll swallow you up.
No, lad. The sea hates phone solicitors that call at mealtime. It'll be the Alps what hates a deserter.
Oh, shucks. I always get those two confused. There's no way that I can have even a drop of lotion?
Well, maybe we could make good. A deal. You see, we need to be repairing the ship. She's leaky as a colander. And for some unknown reason, the ship's supplies of tar have been depleted. How the previous crew could set sail without any tar aboard eludes me. But the fact is, unless we get us some tar or something like it, we're doomed to this island for good. Aye, I'd give you the whole bloomin' bottle of lotion if you could find me something to patch the ship.
Oh, I got
so
it.
So we can be on our way home.
I'll let you get back to work.
I got it. I just need a bucket. Something to keep it in to get it over here. I totally got your stuff, man. How do I get it to him, though? Like, is there a chip maker and a fork? Am I got a bucket or something? We know we're on the right trail. I tried using the pan. It won't let me use the pan.
This pie pan won't do any good there.
Make some chips.
That doesn't need to be left.
Like, I don't know what to keep it in.
I can't use the umbrella with that. The lava has really heated up the barbecue. That melted cheese looks just like yellow tar. I guess I'll just drag this down to Haggis now. Here, Haggis. This stuff should work to patch up the ship.
Aye, laddie, indeed it should. The consistency of tar, but with a tangy pepper taste.
So, can I have
that
your
lotion
now? Aye, lad. Go ahead and take it.
Sweet. All right, let's go get Elaine. Slippery, greasy hand lotion with cursed diamond ring.
Let's see if this slippery, greasy lotion does the trick. That should do it.
Sweet.
Curse ring exploded.
And we'll remove the curse with the diamond ring that doesn't have a curse on it.
Elaine, are you all right?
Guybrush? When? Where are we?
You're okay. We're on Blood Island. LeChuck's ring had a terrible curse on it, but I put everything right.
Yeah.
You're safe and everything's gonna be fine. Just fine.
We might beat this tonight. If we beat this tonight, it's gonna feel good. Oh, we're gonna beat this tonight.
Well spoken, pet. But save your breath, lass.
It was unexpected, but we're gonna do it.
You'll be needing it for when you scream. I do.
Where are we?
Don't you be remembering this place, Freepwood. 'Twas not long ago that I trapped ye here to suffer tortures most foul.
Wait.
Oh, I can remember. Was that in Peru?
I've seen this place before.
You went to Peru.
Some terrible nightmare.
'Twas no mere nightmare.
I keep forgetting where you went.
Search your feelings. You know it to be true.
Oh no. It can't be. But it is. This is the Carnival of the Damned.
Aye. The Carnival of the Damned.
You fiend. Why have you brought us here?
There'll be two reasons, you pathetic privateer. I be intending to torture and kill ye. And I'll be giving Elaine a treasure.
You're wasting your time, LeChuck. Elaine's love can't be bought.
Ah, but this be a very special treasure. This be the fabled treasure of Big Whoop.
Big Whoop?
Aye, the very pirate treasure you were searching for before I caught up with ye.
What's so special about the treasure of Big Whoop?
What's so special about the treasure of Big Whoop? Isn't it just like any other pirate treasure?
I see. Ye do not yet know the dreadful power that be Big Whoop.
I guess not.
Quake in fear, Freepwood, when I tell thee that Big Whoop be a damned portal to a demon netherworld.
Okay.
The treasures of Big Whoop be the very gates of hell themselves!
So dramatic.
Yipe.
But how will Big Whoop make Elaine love you?
But how will Big Whoop make Elaine love you?
Elaine shall pass through the hoary gates of Big
Whoop. Hoary gates.
Just as I once did.
Hoary gates.
Down to the inky blackness of the infernal nether regions. For you see, Big Whoop gives those who pass through it the greatest gift of all. Immortality.
But at what cost?
Granted, the people may find me a bit unapproachable now. And the smell does take a while to get used to. But it'd be worth everything now that I have the power to make Elaine love me.
If you kill Elaine, won't she hate you more? This whole amusement park, why? Please don't kill me. I've heard enough of your evil stories.
But if you kill Elaine, won't she hate you even more?
Aye, at first. But soon she'll be understanding what a grand gift eternal life be. And besides, the dating pool be surprisingly small when you're the living dead.
Yeah, he did.
She'll
it was,
just have to give me he pulled a Shatner. Chance.
But at what cost?
I've heard enough of your evil stories. Let's get this over with.
But there'll be so many more horrible things I'd be wanting to tell you.
I'm not listening to you anymore. See, I'm ignoring you.
You'd better listen.
La 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 la.
La 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 la. I can't hear you. La 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 la.
Very well, Freepwood.
They are.
If you're going to act like a child, I'll help you get in the mood. I think you deserve a timeout, young man.
Yikes.
What did he do?
It's not locked. Your plan was flawless, LeChuck, except for one minor detail. That will be your downfall.
I'm a child. Oh, Murray.
He's taking Elaine on his roller coaster of death. I've got to reach her before she becomes his undead bride. What's happened to me? Head foggy. Can't think. Mind swimming. Must concentrate.
and rescue Elaine. I've got to save Elaine. But how can I save Elaine when I'm just a little boy? Oh, if only I could think straight. Must clear my mind.
Welcome to the Big Whoop Carnival, little guy. Come on over here and meet your old
dog. Yeah, I'll drink the Henby Clear.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Dude, that's awesome. It's genius. Oh, I don't have my Henby Clear, but I know how to... Oh, but do I know how to get it? Okay. Hair of the dog that bit you, right? One egg, pepper, hair of the dog that bit you. One egg, pepper, and then hair of the dog that bit you. We need meringue pie for sure, because it's got egg whites in it.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
I just want one of those pies.
Yeah? Well, I just want out of this stinking rathead. Life's tough, kid. Cope. Hey! You're too little to use that cannon, kid. And wait for one of the older boys to come along, huh?
But I really want to fire it.
It's too dangerous for a little boy to use.
I'm not a little boy. I'm 20 years old.
Right, and I'm Dingy Dog.
I don't know. Does Link have to be in love with Zelda?
Half-pint little punk! Get lost before I have to do something you're gonna regret.
I can't go back there. I'm deathly afraid of mimes.
Oh, gosh. What are we gonna do?
I have to wonder if he's genuinely content with this line of work.
Let's talk to Murray. He might have answers.
Yo, Murray.
Hey, it's you. Are you dead yet? You look different.
Not dead, Murray. Just cursed.
Cursed? That's perfect. I'm cursed too. Let's join our cursed forces together, and together we can rule the world.
Yeah. Let me get back to you on that.
Let's see, we need hair of the dog that bit you, an egg, and a pepper. Let's talk to this guy.
What kind of snow cones do you have?
What kind of cones did you ask? Why, I have every kind imaginable. I have the most distinct type of snow cones in the world. In fact, my cones are so original, so inventive, and so unique.
Health department.
That most are completely inedible. Let me list some for you. I have sweet cones, meat cones, cold cones, mold cones, bold cones with lime, cones with slime. Veggie cones, wedgie cones, hedgie cones. I used some of my neighbor's edge in that one. Cones with spice, cones with lice, berry cones, hairy cones, dairy cones, and the Christmas, merry cones. So, what do you think of that?
I'd like a plain snow cone, please.
Okay, kid. Bye now.
Alright, so I got a snow cone. Don't know what good that's gonna do me yet.
Oops, my snow cone melted.
Soggy paper cone.
It's all that's left of my snow cone. That doesn't need to be lathered up.
Eh, figured I'd try. Pizza making, yeah.
How can I win one of these fabulous prizes?
Well, that's easy, matey. If I can't guess your weight or your age, you get to pick what you want.
What's the catch?
There's no catch. It's just that easy.
I'll bet you can't guess how old I am.
Bet you I can. A little fearsome buccaneer like yourself must be 7 years old.
Ha! Wrong. I just so happen to be 20.
Well, do you have any proof for your old pal Dingy Dog?
You calling me a liar?
You bet I am.
I have my proof right here.
Scum Actors Guild membership card. Guybrush Threepwood, age 20. I suppose you're right. Pick your prize.
I don't know what I want. Smuggle Bunny set me up with a toy cannon. Oh, I bought one of those toy voodoo dolls. One Smuggle Bunny.
One Smuggle Bunny, please.
Well, what do you know? Seems like your buddy Dingy Dog forgot to mention
of
something.
Of course.
I see. Typical. I suppose you're telling me that's one of your prestige prizes now.
You bet I am. Would you like to play again?
Okay.
All righty. I would guess that you are 20 years old.
Wait a second. That's not fair.
Neither is life, son. You learned a valuable lesson today, and that's the best prize of all. Choose again.
Oh.
I really want that talking skull.
With my unfettered demonic might, we will rule the world.
You're right, Murray. If I had all that power, the temptation for evil would be too great. I'll take the anchor.
Well, take it away, son. Congratulations.
I know what to do with
Enjoy
the anchor.
Enjoy your stay here at Big Whoop. Now that's not very nice, little boy.
Look into your heart.
Come on, now stop hitting your pal Dingy Dog. I'm not gonna warn you again.
I'm gonna keep
kid.
Punching him.
You better cut that out.
Free me, my brother. And...
Yeah, you're really starting to bug me, kid. All right. That does it. You're going down, little punk.
Yeah, I got some hair of the dog that bit me.
Give me back that hair, kid. You're ruining the suit.
I got some hair
of
the dog. Where's that anchor? Oh, I gotta pick it up.
You know I'm the best toy on the shelf. What? You picked the anchor?
It's a really nice anchor, Murray. Sorry.
Sorry. All right.
I can't believe you picked that Stay away from those!
Why are you
what
yelling?
What's a dumb hunk of iron anyway? It's not even a real anchor.
Ew.
Yeah, kid, what is it?
Yikes, what is that horrible smell?
It's a giant rat suit, you little brat! What did you expect, roses?
What are you guys doing here?
It's Blow the Man Down, the most fun in the Midway. Hit the funny clown and win a fantastic prize. Watch the pies fly from the cannon with blinding speed and loud report. And if your aim is true, go home with your winnings. Join in the laughs with your happy sailor host, Wharf Rat, and his pal, Monty Meringue.
What flavor?
What?
What flavor are the pies today?
I don't know. Lemon meringue, I think. What kind of a stupid question
I
is that?
I love lemon meringue pie. Mmm.
I want to shoot the cannon. I want to shoot the cannon.
Sorry, little boy. You're too young. Blow the Man Down is for older kids.
That's discrimination. How do I know it really works if I can't see it go off?
Okay, kid, you want to see the cannon fire? Here we go.
I want to put the anchor in the pies.
How does this whole booth work again?
It's not that complex a concept, kid. Fire pies from the cannon at the guy in a clown suit. You hit him and win a prize. It's great fun.
Am I the only one nauseated by that terrible stench?
Okay, the suit smells. We've heard it. Everybody just come over and pick on the giant rat man.
What's Dingy Dog really like in person?
What are you asking me for? I'm just a giant rat. I'm not allowed to associate with His Highness, the great and mighty Dingy Dog.
All right, fine.
Never mind.
All right, we gotta put this.
It's not even a real anchor.
I wonder if he does. He look away.
I'm a real talking skull. Beat it.
Doesn't.
Now it's a heavy pie
oh.
pan.
After all we've been through
Now I've got a heavy pie pan full of shaving cream.
Yeah.
What are you doing over there?
I found this pie, mister.
We made a pie. So we had to use the pie pan for something.
Shoot it, shoot it.
Not right now.
Oh, but I want to see the cannon fire.
Beat cheeks, half pint.
Look, man, I pay your salary. You want me to tell LeChuck you've got unhappy kids running around here?
Okay, oh, we're about to watch
a mime take it in the face.
Did you just hear something?
No.
Weird.
Maybe it's the acoustics of that smelly giant head.
Shut up, kid.
That was awesome. All right, let's open the gate.
Fine. Take the stupid anchor.
Murray's so mad at me.
You would have made a lousy undead monster anyway.
Yoo-hoo, stinky Mr. Rat.
Hey, get out of there, you little punk.
What are you gonna do about it, vermin boy?
This'll teach you.
That's what I needed.
I'm going to wait for an owner who understands.
I'd rather keep these pie bits for a better time. Like oil and water. I'd rather keep these pie bits for a better time.
All right.
Get out of
so
here.
So we need a pepper.
I call up the demonic legions of Hades and set them upon you like a
or something
of
that will
locusts.
Function as a pepper.
If you value your life, mere mortal, you will flee before Murray, scourge of the living, and Uber of the underworld.
Now I've got all the pieces.
And that doesn't need more seasoning.
Got all the pieces, but now I need to make the drink.
Like oil and water. I'd rather keep these pie bits for a better time. And that doesn't need more seasoning.
Yeah, we do. We're trying to make a thingy.
It's a bunch of bits of meringue from the pie.
Let's see.
I'll take that old snow cone for you.
Thanks. I'd like a plain snow cone, please.
Okay, kid.
Let's see, we won't walk very far this time. Let's see if we can just...
Bye now.
Put this together on this pie. There we go.
Peppery goodness. That meringue looks tasty. Ooh, hairy.
There we go.
Ooh. The pepper helps, though.
brain freeze.
Nah, right now I'm just trying to beat the game. I don't want to... Murray's not going to come with me. We're close. Yes! We're going to beat this, you guys. We're going to beat it. We're going to beat it before the stream is over.
Too late for me to get out.
Gotta remember how this goes. Hey, there's Wally. I remember this scene, I think. Yeah. I'm just kind of getting an idea of what we're looking at here. Everybody needs a rope.
I had a feeling he'd turn up sooner or later.
It's a little coffin. That's creepy.
By itself, this rope would make a lousy view.
Alright. Got two things we need. Oh, crap.
Elaine! Ah! Frankwood is only you. Have you seen Elaine?
Do you think about how horrifying that would actually be?
And I haven't seen her since. I can't even believe that I fell for that one again. Now stand still, boy, so I can flame broil.
No, get out of here. Jump!
Darn it.
Ouch! Ow!
It's a Dynamo Monk Electric Wally.
Egad.
So lifelike. Hey, wait a minute. He really is Wally. Could you please stop that annoying swinging?
Boom, boom, boom. This, apologies, but I remember this too because, you know, things happen. It's the end of the game, and I played this game
a lot.
It's
one of those inflammable Dynamo Monk Electric ropes. It'd make a lousy fuse.
What? Why would it make a lousy fuse? Maybe I have to dip it into something. Well, at least I know I'm onto something.
Great big keg of rum.
Lousy fuse. Well, what would make a good fuse?
It's one of those inflammable Dynamo Monk Electric ropes. It'd make a lousy fuse.
Go. Ah.
I missed that car.
Wait, wait, wait. Oh, here he is. The shaving oil. Oh.
Ah,
I think I used it already, though, didn't I?
If you've ridden me, Coaster, why haven't you been boiled in me molten pool of lava? Elaine must have fiddled with me controls and rerouted the tracks. Aye, she'll be the death of me yet. I mean, again. Cursed as if I can't help but love the little woman. Eat flame and death, Drakewood.
All right, fine, fine.
Darn.
Ouch! Ow!
Don't think there's anything here. These guys I've already dealt with. Because I just need the keg of rum. This one's the one I was sure about.
I'll save him after I defeat LeChuck. You can count on me, Wally. Just as soon as I defeat LeChuck, save Elaine, set all the monkeys free, and ride the madly rotating buccaneer, I'll come back and release you.
What's this thing?
It's a replica of the torture
lantern
in LeChuck's palace from back in his zombie days.
Oh, fire. Flask of oil.
Ouch! That's rude.
God damn it. I gotta go around again.
Oh no,
but I'm on to it.
I, Threepwood. It be me, your worst nightmare. You'll be sorry you ever set foot here on Monkey Island when I'm through with you.
All right, do the thing. I'll jump off and ride around again. I was close. No haste at all. You're right.
Ouch.
Plus, he's kind of got some weak spells. He just aims at my feet all the time. All right, roll on. He's affliction. Okay, roll, 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 roll. We're close. We're so close. Poor Wally. Oh,
too late for me to get out.
Dagnabbit. I thought I was waiting for the stupid snow ride. I wasn't paying attention. Ah. This is the part where you just get to watch me roll around again. No, I don't want to screw that up this time. I started waiting and I was just daydreaming a little bit, thinking, aw, Wally's hanging there. How unfortunate. That's terrible. And now we're gonna, we're gonna grab that flask of oil and we're gonna get down to business.
There, it's soaked in oil and probably highly flammable.
There we go. It's like they've gotta make the puzzles a little bit challenging. All right, jump in. And get out here. We're gonna stop him. Coming for you, LeChuck.
Cool.
I think this is the only thing we have to do.
It's a piece of rope soaked in lamp oil.
So I don't think I need anything else. I think we just gotta figure out how to get LeChuck to hit it. With this fire, it aims at my feet all the time.
Till you be my undead slave, Threepwood.
Darn.
Ow.
Ouch. Ow.
All right, we gotta do something else. We need more rope?
I can't reach it up there.
Ew.
What do we have? What do we need to do? Ah, dang. There he comes. Uh-oh. Push him? So maybe I can do something to him. I bet I do something to him. I wonder if I make him sneeze or something and throw that pepper mill at him. That'd be kind of interesting. We could try that.
I don't want to waste it.
That seems like it could be a thing that you do. All right, LeChuck. So we can't push him. We can use him somehow. All right, here he is.
Darn, here he comes.
Aye, and I'll keep a-coming after ye for as long as it takes to make ye one of the undead.
Ha! Yes. Yes. We did it. We kicked LeChuck's butt again. We have done it, ladies and gentlemen. Right on.
Run, mortal. But do not forget your arch nemesis, Murray. Mark my words, I shall return to haunt you. Do you hear me? I shall return.
Murray. That's awesome, guys. That's the end, dude.
This is so unfair.
We just beat Monkey Island 3. That's awesome. So what this means for us from a stream point of view is that we have, so March 30th is when Thimbleweed Parks comes out. March 30th is a Thursday, I think, so I won't be able to play it with you guys till the following Tuesday. So we're gonna try. I'm gonna try to figure out what to do with adventure games for those 3 weeks because I don't want to commit to another one and then not be able to beat it, especially if it's a new one I've never played before. If I can't beat it in those 3 weeks, then it would be kind of a bummer. So we are going to do what we can to figure out something to put in place of it. Yes, something could change. We might play Stardew. I could probably beat Grim Fandango in 3 weeks. I'm not 100% sure that I would have the time. Because it would, roughly 6 hours is how much I would have in 3 weeks to complete a game. But we'll see. Hey, Hascatman, thanks for the follow. You are awesome. Really appreciate that. Thank you so much for joining in. And joining the Legion of Dorks. But we're going to have, I don't know. We'll see. We might play Skyrim. We might play some Stardew. We might play just something off kilter. That just kind of gets us through that until we get to Thimbleweed Park. Thimbleweed Park I'm really excited about because it is a Ron Gilbert and Gary Winnick game, who are the original writers and creators of the Maniac Mansion series. There it is.
Welcome to the Legion of Dorks.
Welcome, Hascat, to the Legion. So we're gonna see how it goes. Might play Stardew. That would actually be pretty fun. Or might play Skyrim. I'm kind of thinking about doing some Skyrim stuff because it's adventure-y. As you say, subject to change. Skyrim is just basically wandering around on adventures. That's what it's for. So we'll see. I don't know. I will let you know when it comes down to it. So you guys are cool. You're awesome. Thank you so much for joining me on the Monkey Island stream. It's been a great... we're going to skip Monkey 4 because it was a big giant pooper and I don't want to play it. So let's just consider this a trilogy complete. We'll do Thimbleweed Park and then we'll figure out what else we can get into. You guys are awesome. Have yourselves a wonderful night. Be cool. Be excellent to each other. Bye!